take on, you know, how difficult is this to play, first of all, and how is she going to be okay?
She's going to be okay.
Yeah.
They haven't told me.
Yeah.
She definitely has a lot to go through before she's okay. So, very humbling storyline. You know, I mean, what are we? There's one man here. But, you know, everyone has to deal with the conversation of getting tested, whether it's for breast and prostate for men. And I think one of the big things for me was to face the fact that I have a mother that has gone through it. My father has gone through prostate, and to commit to telling an authentic storyline. And that was very, you know, one of my acting coaches always said to me, acting is not acting, it's living. And this one has been real. It is real. When you think about it, even that first episode of the test, I'm not sure, but that tear wasn't hard to bring up. Yeah. So, yeah.
And kind of going off that, you obviously just mentioned that your mother went through it and your father, but like, did you have to do any research or like, did you spend time with people who are currently going through it to help prepare for what Maggie's going through?
I did all three. So the first thing I did was I started at home. And I first started with asking my mother how I reacted to it. Because I know how I think I reacted to it. It is not what my mother saw. And that's interesting because my mother saw that I had a difficulty coping. I wasn't ready to lose my mother. It shocks your family when it does happen. It turns every situation into a heightened life experience. It's almost like it changes your taste, it changes your sight, everything. The touch that you know, so many times say goodbye to your parents, they kind of gotta go. But that hug suddenly has a tactile sensory that increases. So I did that, and then I researched the disease itself. What was the idea of cancer and why is it still around? You know, I always think about like the measles and things like that. Why are we still dealing with cancer? Like, we make iPhones and we got one coming out like every 2 minutes. Like, surely there's something we can figure out about this thing. So then I started the disease, how we are approaching it, what is the process of finding a cure, and then approaching women who had lived through it was another process. So I did extensive research from the moment I found out that the kidney was infected in season 4. I started that research process.
What do you think
stories
are important to like have this, especially from like your
out to people. I think I connected with Frodo in Lord of the Rings, even though it was imaginary, and then the ghouls are coming. There's something that was real about his relationship with Sam. There's something that was real about leaving home and feeling like you're being hunted when you have to tell you to follow your dream. There's real things that you have to portray in order to connect with people. You know, and I also think that through tragedy, you've got to learn how to laugh. You know, illness can be illness, but may never take your joy away. So, there's something about the episodes where Maggie comes out and she's still laughing that I love, you know?
So, what's one of the best things about coming to work on the show?
The squad. Hearing, like, Tori and Nico, they're like laughing. Like, there's just, we have a really fun squad, a fun group of people. You never stop. And the friendships. I mean, you make some really great friends here, too. And it's some really good writing. And the success doesn't hurt.
Right. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know?
Speaking of the writing,
I'm just going to go here. I'm going to tag
you. Yes,
I felt like you were going to tap me. Go ahead.
What are some of those parallels that you see between you? That you can like tap into when you have those more intense moments with her.
Her vulnerability, her frailty. little bit more than me, though. Her
transparency. The journey. But for Maggie, it seems like coming from the south side of Chicago and making her way to one of the best hospitals in the city has been a journey of believing in such a way. I think I am like that in my acting career. Like I was able to hustle through and really just dive into, but I think I already had in me the desire to study. But Maggie has a lot of things to
do. Oh, okay. So I was going to ask about the big thing coming up, which is the
crossover.
That trailer is
monstrous, right?
Bananas.
Yes.
Tell us about what we can expect and what's been fun about filming.
One, I'll say that Lord of the Rings got 3 years. We got a month. But our trailer's as good. And also, you know, it's like 20-something cast members. It's one city. And I believe Chicago is actually the patient in this one. And Chicago, in this situation, kind of represents the U.S. Because you hear about all these different types of wars, rumors all around. And you wonder sometimes, you know, is biological warfare a possibility? Yup. Remember anthrax and all those crazy things? So you don't know what people are capable of doing. And I think what Dick, as I see the boss right there, I think no one does it like Dick to take a story that is so close to home and to bring reality to it. Yeah.
But that being said, like, if you had to describe it in 5 words, like, how cool would you pick? Or 5 words.
Boom would be the first one. Captivating. Human. Transparent. And heroic.
I like those.
That's fantastic.
Those would be my words. Outside of sex. Fly. Hot. Great scrubs. I think we have the best scrubs ever.
You have amazing scrubs.
Thank you. Well, you know, biological warfare is such an interesting thing because until someone creates something, you don't have a replica of something. So, biology is definitely, you have to find the crazy combo before the crazy. So, yeah.
So one of our favorite friendships that we talk about a lot on our podcast is Maggie and Will, and just that relationship. And I was just curious, like, we love seeing that he supports her, and she's kind of one that only person that can, like, tell him straight and, like, see how things go. What can we expect from that friendship as, like, the season goes on and progresses?
You know, some friendships are just isms, you know? I think Will and Maggie are brother and sister. And there's a lot of pain in watching Will and Natalie go through what they're going through. Yeah. And wondering, I think secretly inside, Maggie really wants them to get back together, but not until they're ready. Because she can also see the pain that they're causing each other. It's like one of those things. There's one episode I remember where Maggie was telling Will, it's about timing. You know, you hear about some great people, and you always have that question, did they meet at the right time? I was blessed enough to meet my husband exactly when I was ready. But I know a lot of people, they're like starstruck lovers. You're like, oh man, she would have worked with them. They were so amazing, you know? So I think right now, she's hurting for her brother. And he's having problems finding his bearings, I feel. So, yeah.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.